respected chairman, Sri V.K. Surendra, vice chairman and managing director, Sri V.P. Mahendra, chief executive officer, Mr. K.U. Subbaya, other directors, dignitaries, the extended family of dealers, vendors, bankers, my fellow colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I once again welcome you all to this historic event. It is indeed my pleasure to be standing here to take you through our journey during the last 50 years. Our Vice Chairman and Managing Director, Sri V.P. Mahendra, assigned me this task probably because I have been working for this company for the last 39 years. And you see, at my age, probably I am fit only for storytelling. So I gladly accepted the role.
VST Tillers Tractors Limited was promoted by the renowned VST Group that has a glorious track record of 107 years. VST stands for Vellur Singaravelu Thiruvengadaswamy Mudaliyar, grandfather of our chairman, as also our managing director, who was into the business of kerosene and petroleum distribution under the banner of VST and Sons. His sons, Sri V.T. Padmanabhan, Sri V.T. Krishnamurthy and Sri V.T. Velu, representing the second generation, expanded the business into distribution of automobiles, starting with Austin cars. All credit goes to them for building the brand of VST Motors and India Garage as a trusted name all over South. VST Tillers Tractors Limited was born out of the collective thinking of these three diamonds of the family. It was a bold decision to explore beyond the comfort zone of trading and automobile business and get into manufacturing agricultural machinery, a segment that was very much needed for the growth of farm mechanization and Indian economy. The family incorporated the company in the year 1967. Soon, Sri V.T. Krishnamurthy and Sri V.T. Velu took over as the managing directors under the chairmanship of Sri V.T. Padmanabhan. The youngest of the brothers, Sri V.T. Velu, whom many of you gathered here will recall as the charismatic and dynamic leader who was instrumental in bringing the renowned Mitsubishi Heavy Industries Japan as a joint venture partner along with the technical collaboration for the manufacture of power tillers. Besides, he drew support of Karnataka state government as another partner in the investment. Many of the stakeholders, the investors in the capital market and mutual funds, and all those who now fancy our shares may not know the travails that the company has gone through in the past. It was really a great struggle before we could achieve an enviable growth record and establish the present position of strength. The power tiller plant was set up in Bangalore with an annual capacity of 5,000 numbers. However, the concept of power tiller being new and the dominance of tractors so high, the demand for power tillers was not even 10% of the installed capacity. As a result, the company suffered huge losses year after year. Other five companies in the race suffered similar fate and four of them pulled down the shutters. I recall my mentor Sri V.T. Velu telling me that by 1977 he had barely a lakh of rupees left and had almost decided to wind up. It was the moral support of his brothers Sri V.T. Padmanabhan and Sri V.T. Krishnamurthy that gave him courage to continue the fight. The grit, determination and above all grace of Lord Ganesha enabled the company to survive and start earning profits. Government policy to give subsidy to farmers for purchase of power tillers was the booster, and the demand for power tillers increased gradually. The financial institutions advised us to look for diversification to increase the capacity utilization and business volume. Their advice prompted us to introduce the compact four-wheel drive Mitsubishi tractors in the year 1985. It was the first of its kind in India and was well received. As the company was about to consolidate for the next phase of growth, misfortune struck again in the form of zooming yen in the international currency market. We had to incur huge inevitable loss of Rs 20,000 per unit on the CKD tractor consignments which were imported. Within a short span, the losses completely eroded the net worth of the company, and it was declared a sick unit under BIFR in the year 1989. Those were the days when BIFR company was similar to a terminally ill patient. The legal rehabilitation process began to take place. It was good that the bankers, financial institutions and the state government appreciated the merits of the case and extended need-based support. Simultaneously, the company took right steps to arrest the damage and initiate appropriate action. The entire team of executives put their minds and heart together to fight the battle. They created a history by recouping the losses and make the company turn around by 1991. In the year 1989, Mr. V.T. Velu passed on the mantle to Sri V.P. Mahendra as the managing director. The smart turnaround, the prudent management and growth potential of the company was well researched by Enam, the reputed merchant bankers in the capital market. They played a key role in our rights issue that was well received. The proceeds enabled us to expand the capacity and set up the second unit at Mysore. The huge success of power tillers in the neighboring countries inspired us to think big. We constantly pursued with the government for due patronage for the cause of industry and small farmers. It boosted the demand in several states such as Odisha, Karnataka, Assam, and enlarged the market base. When we surpassed 10,000 power tillers in the year 2007, it was an occasion to celebrate. With the steady growth from 10,000 to 30,000 power tillers, we continue to be the leaders in the market despite intense competition from more than 40 brands of imported and domestic power tillers. Meanwhile, the demand for compact tractors was also growing. The consistent generation of profit gave us confidence to set up a state-of-the-art plant at Hosur, exclusively for the manufacture of tractors. Tractor production has increased from 5,000 to over 11,000, and we have established as a major player in sub-30 HP segment. The steady growth in business and profits enabled the company to declare handsome dividend and also issue bonus shares twice in the year 1998 and 2010. It is gratifying to note that employees, vendors, dealers, institutions, in short, all the stakeholders are happy to have been associated with us. We believe that it is largely because of our human approach to all aspects of business. Building long-term association through trust and concern has been the essence of our corporate culture. We are proud to say that hardly any employee resigned from the service. More than 50% of the employees completing over 25 years of continuous service speaks for the great sense of belonging. Most of our dealers and vendors have been with us for more than 3 decades through thick and thin. They will recollect the days when they were supplying or selling hardly 50 units a month, and now some of them grown 50 to 100 times. All through these 5 decades of journey, our dealers and vendors never lost their faith but always stuck to the company. Looking back, it resembles a fairy tale of crossing 7 oceans and mountains before settling to a happy life. Once upon a time, there are no buyers for our shares of rupees 100 quoted at a discount of rupees 30. They were split into shares of rupees 10 each, and yet they are currently being traded at more than rupees 2600 after two bonus issue. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives us immense pride to take a quick look at the dream run. Struggling to sell few hundred tillers a year to now scale 30,000 power tillers and grow from 1,000 to over 11,000 tractors. Parking place for employees was filled with only cycles and a lonely car. Now we can see the place packed with motorbikes and dozens of cars. We are proud that near to our head office, we have built row houses for our executives. A debt-ridden sick unit being able to set up a new tractor plant, investing rupees 70 crores without borrowing a single rupee. From a single product company struggling for more than a decade, we are the only company to offer power tiller, tractor, transplanter, weeder and reaper, thus providing total solution for paddy mechanization with a range of machines. Recently, we have signed a technical collaboration with Kukje Korea for the manufacture of tractors in the higher horsepower range. In this phase of growth, we have expanded the operations to four locations. Once a sick child in the VST family group, emerging as a jewel in the crown with highest return on investment and growth. What were the main reasons or contributing factors to this remarkable growth and success of VST tillers? It would make a good management case study to analyze the success story. A single line answer would not do justice to the 50 years of corporate journey. Our founder managing director, late Sri V.T. Velu, always kept saying that it was the grace of Lord Ganesha. The company's fortune changed after the idol was retraced and installed in the backyard. While we don't disbelieve, we all give equal credit to the charismatic personality of Sri V.T. Velu, who was the binding force for all the employees and stakeholders. He served the company without drawing any remuneration for more than 20 years before handing over the reins. Ladies and gentlemen, it would be a lapse on our part not to remember the support given by our promoters, VST Group. Without their care and support in the formative years, the sick child would not have survived. For a long time, it was difficult to get dealers for power tillers, and the company could not afford to have its own office for sales and service. It was VST Motors and India Garage, the household names in South India, who played the role of dealers for Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Pondicherry, and instilled brand image. Besides financial support, the family members were dedicated to the cause of the company. Sri V.T. Velu drew support from his nephews, Sri V.K. Surendra, Sri V.P. Mahendra, late Sri A.T. Nahendar, and in the later years, his younger son, Sri V.V. Pravindra. Sri V.K. Surendra, son of Sri V.T. Krishnamurti, and the eldest of the third generation, has been our chairman since 1996. Known for his business acumen and financial management, he is also guiding the total group business. Our chairman has been the driving force to draw the blueprint for corporate succession plan. He has been a source of guidance and inspiration to the young generation for accelerating the growth of the company. Late Sri A.T. Nahendar, who was the director of operations, was known for his passionate involvement and discipline, built the technical capabilities of the company. He was instrumental in upgrading the power tillers, bringing in Mitsubishi technical collaboration for tractors, information systems, setting up the plant at Mysore, and guiding relations with the employees' union. He was also the brain behind the incorporation of Mitsubishi VST engine plant at Mysore. It is difficult to summarize the role played by our Vice Chairman and Managing Director, Shri V.P. Mahendra. In the year 1967, he chose to abort his studies in IIM Calcutta to take charge of the marketing and administrative functions of the company right from day one. Known for his simplicity, empathy and patience, he can pierce through all kinds of people and weather all situations by his stride with a disarming smile of detachment. He was able to quickly fill the void created by the untimely demise of Shri A.T. Nahender and lead the team of executives to strengthen the company. Shri V.P. Mahendra has been a role model for all the employees and executives to learn austerity and the art of managing with scarce resources. Above all, we see in Shri V.P. Mahendra a kind person, down-to-earth and humility personified. Ladies and gentlemen, the company takes pride to inform you that Mr. V.P. Mahendra has completed glorious 50 years of dedicated service to VST Tillus Tractors Limited. The house will appreciate that it is a rare feat in the annals of corporate history. Ladies and gentlemen, may I request all of you to give him a standing ovation. Thank you, Mr. Mahendra. I must mention the role of Sri V.V. Pravindra as the Deputy Managing Director of the company from 1996 until 2008. Due to other priorities of the family group, he had to take charge of automobile business. During his tenure, he made significant contribution to the growth of the company. His rapport with the employees union, overseeing the working of Mysore plant, building excellent executive team coordination will always be remembered. Ladies and gentlemen, the credit titles are not complete. The promoters and directors give full marks to the team of executives and all the employees who passionately stood by the company with total dedication and involvement. Particularly, when the company was declared sick, it was an entirely in-house strategic game plan of the executives in the form of business plan committee. Working together to the pre-designed plan, perform and accomplish missions such as pulling out the company from the clutches of BIFR, making VST debt-free, VST a corporate blue chip. We want, we can, we will. Performance, our best spokesperson. Gaining recognition for powerlessness in the Indian agriculture scenario. We are proud that we reached and cohesive working of the team of executives to build the company that made the mission to succeed. The company did not seek any external support or guidance in this mission, as it did not think it was necessary, nor could it afford such a luxury. Failing in our duty if we do not mention the support of the state government. It was not only a joint venture partner but gave financial assistance to bail the company while it was in the verge of closure. Again, it is due to the subsidy schemes of the Bahrain state government that we could increase the market from few hundred power tillers to over 5000 numbers every year in Karnataka and also make our tractors popular. Many of our dealers are also in the business of other non-competing products and exposed to other companies. However, as mentioned earlier, what is significant is the fact that most of them are stuck to VST for more than 3 decades. So what is it that is unique in VST to have a prime and permanent place in their business? Analyzing the reasons, a senior and esteemed dealer summed it up beautifully, which I quote, "VST Tillers has a soul which other companies lack." Ladies and gentlemen, I might have taken much of your time. One reason is, I have retired after playing a long innings. So let me make the best use of the last opportunity that has come to me. Zindagi na milegi dubara. No, the real intention is, we want the posterity to know its roots, history and culture of VST Tillers. Never forget the shoulders that enabled us to grow to its present position of pride and success. It is natural that the world order has to change, and we are sure the company is in the able hands of the younger generation. Sri V.T. Ravindra, the young director, represents the fourth generation of VST family on the board. He, along with Sri K.U. Subbaiah as the CEO, has been the driving force and are laying foundation for accelerated growth in future. We look to them and their team for taking the company to greater heights. At the same time, cherish and preserve our most treasured legacy, the corporate DNA. May I take this opportunity to thank all of you and request all the stakeholders for their continued trust and support to the younger generation and lead VST Tillers Tractor Limited to the glorious century path. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much.